Hello, B here, and welcome back to Integrated Physics and Chemistry. We use water in our lives every day. It is essential to our survival and the survival of life on Earth. The water cycle is the process by which water moves around the Earth, on, above, and below the surface. But how does water accomplish this? It utilizes its phase changes. It moves between solid, liquid, and gas states to move through the Earth and support life. In this lesson, we will learn more about the individual phase changes and what happens on the particle level during these changes. But before we get started, let's look at our goals for this lesson. By the end, you'll be able to identify the key phase changes of matter. Discuss the process of a phase change and what is occurring at a particle level during those changes. For now, why don't we continue to focus on water as our main example as we discuss phase changes? Let's start with water in the gaseous state, otherwise called water vapor. Since water vapor is a gas, its particles are moving extremely fast. What do you think happens as you cool water vapor? As it cools, the particles start slowing down, and eventually, the water molecules become slower and more organized, forming liquid water. This process of matter changing from a gas to a liquid is called condensation. Okay, let's keep cooling down that water. Now, as we cool the liquid water, the particles continue to slow down even more. Eventually, we all know what happens. It turns to ice, which is a solid. What do we call the process of a liquid turning into a solid? Freezing. Okay, let's turn it around and go back the other way. Picture an ice cube sitting on the counter. As it warms up, what happens? Well, on a particle level, the water molecules start heating up and gaining more energy, therefore moving more quickly. On a practical level, the ice goes through the process of melting. What if we keep heating up the water molecules? They will keep vibrating and moving, and eventually, they will start moving so quickly that they enter the gas phase. This process of going from a liquid to a gas is called evaporation. Another way to look at phase changes is to use a phase curve. Let's start by looking carefully at the x and y axis of these graphs to help us better understand what we're looking at. The y axis is measuring the temperature. If you look closely, you will notice there isn't a specific temperature listed, but just the general boiling point and melting point. This is because every substance has a different temperature at which it melts and boils. Boiling is just another name for evaporation, or when matter changes from a liquid to a gas. The x-axis is measuring time. Again, there are no specific times listed, so the axis is just referencing the passage of time, as starting with time zero, at the origin to the right. Now that we understand how the graph is organized, let's talk about what it says. Starting at time zero, the matter is a solid at a cool temperature. As time increases, what do you notice happens to the temperature of the matter? It is also increasing. This continues until the temperature hits the melting point. At this moment, the temperature stops increasing as all of the solid melts into liquid. This means that the forces and bonds holding the solid together in its tightly packed shape are slowly breaking, allowing the particles to move a little more freely as a liquid. Once melting is complete, the temperature begins to rise again, but now the matter is a liquid. Eventually, the temperature hits the boiling temperature of the matter. Once again, as the phase change occurs, both states of matter exist at the same time as the forces and bonds between the liquid particles break, allowing the gas particles to move with more energy. During this time, there is no increase in temperature. Once all of the matter has shifted to the gas state, the temperature will continue to rise again. In the lesson PDF, you will get a chance to study and explore the opposite curve that shows what happens when you heat matter instead of cool it. As we went through the lesson today, we learned about the various states of matter and the process matter takes as it changes from one phase to another. In our next lesson, you will complete a PHET simulation on the states of matter and phase changes. Until next time, remember, the universe is vast and full of surprises, so never stop exploring. Hey, hey.